Hi, in this video we will learn a flexible way to create freeform shapes like the one you see here. A flexible way means that you can modify the shape easily, add and delete details at any time. Here you will see that I have some random shapes. But with this technique you can create many other shapes. You can create like roads that goes up and down and many other geometry. For example, here I only needed to create one, and then I copied and I modified it very easily to create the other ones. As you can see, they have thickness and rounded corners. So we will start by creating a new max file and start from scratch. I will do reset. Don't save. Yes. Okay. First, I will create a line. Go to shape, line. Now I will make two copies from this line. I will use move, press shift, then click. I will choose two to make two copies. I will move this one a little bit here. Now, second thing we need to do is to attach those three lines to make them one spline object. I will choose this one, choose attach, and this is important, the order that you attach the lines, because the surface that will be created, it will respect the order that you attach those lines. So I will attach this one first and this one. This way now the surface will be created starting from here. Then it will pass through this segment, then it will end up here. Now the second thing we need to do is to go to modifier list and look for the cross-section modifier. As you can see, a cross-section has been created. This tool works by connecting the vertices together with lines. So this vertex is connected to this one with a line, then this one with a line, etc. Now you have options here. If you choose linear, the transition from the first segment to the last one is linear. That means a straight line will be created between this vertex, and another straight line is created between this vertex and this vertex. If I choose smooth, the transition is smooth shape. So I will keep this option. At any time I can go back to line, click on segment. If I like to add, I will choose show end result. This way, while I'm working here, I can see the end results of all the modifiers. So I can click here and press shift, then move. Now I created a new segment. Okay, now I need to create the surface. Again, modifier list, look for a tool called surface. Now a surface is created. Now as you can see, I'm looking to the back side, back face. So I can click flip normals. I will press F4 also to see the wireframe. If you don't like to see those selection brackets, you can press the G on the keyboard. G like Jasmine. Okay, now first, for this tool to work, you need a closed shape. The closed shape has to be made of four sided, like this one here, one segment, two, three, four, or three segments, like triangle. But it will not work if you have more than four closed segments. It will not work if those, like, for example, if I have five, it will not work. Only three or four segments. Okay. Now, the second thing I will do, the third thing I will do, I will add an edit poly modifier. Now, the reason why I did this, even though I will not use the tools inside the edit poly, because I need to have quad polygons. Quads means a polygon with four sided. The reason for that is because I know at the end I will add a turbo smooth. And turbo smooth will give you unpredictable results if you have three-sided polygons or five or whatever. If I don't add the edit poly, now this surface under the hood, everything in Max is made of triangles. So if I don't use this, if I don't put this one, and then at the end I use the turbo smooth, the result will be unpredictable and most probably undesirable result. So when I put the edit poly, has this advantage, is that its polygons is made of four edges. So now I have my geometry made of quads. Now the what I want to do now is give it a thickness. I can do that by adding a shell modifier. I already have a shortcut for it here, but you can find it also here. Shell, it will give a thickness to your geometry, to your faces. I can increase it or decrease it, or I can make it zero and make this thickness goes in this direction. Now I can add a turbo smooth. At what the turbo smooth does, it will add a turbo smooth with one iteration. It will take each polygon and subdivide it to four polygons with iteration of one. If I make it two, each new polygon from those four will also be divided to another four. So one polygon will become here, this polygon will become 16 if I make it two iterations. So now what I can do, if I want to create those random shapes that you saw before, I can go back to segment here. Remember to keep this option on so you can see the end result while you are working here. I can now move it. I can go scale it. Say scale this one. And I can start to play around with it the way I want. I can press shift, then move to create a copy. Let's say I can rotate it, scale. As you can see, now I can before that, let's say I want to maintain some flat area here. I can go back to shell, F4 to see. I can choose here. I can increase the segments from 1 to, let's say, 3. This way, this polygon with the turbo smooth will be subdivided to 16, and this one will be subdivided to 16, and the transition will be smooth between this one and this one, and this one here with this one. And but those three here, since they are planar, they will stay flat. So if you look here, for example, now as you can see, the smoothness is happening here and here and here. It's flat. If this is what you want, I can go to shell and decrease the thickness, go back to smooth. Oh, sorry, I made a mistake. I increased the turbo smooth to 10 by mistake. Sorry, I had a crash on my computer because by mistake I increased the turbo smooth iteration to 10. I will delete it and make another turbo smooth. Okay, like I was saying here, the shell, I made the segments 3, so I can preserve a flat portion here between those polygons in this part, and the smoothness will happen between those and on this side and here down between the between this one and this one and this one and the one on the back, and between those three here it will remain flat. So I will turn on turbo smooth again, as you can see. So now I have this shape. I can go back to segment and continue modify it. And I can rotate this one. Now I can make a copy of this one. Okay, press shift, right? And now this one, I can go here and start. I will click show end result. I can modify it. Here, for example, I can click shift and drag to create another segment. Play around with it. And you, I think you got the idea. And you can experiment, create you can create many shapes, many geometries using this technique. It's very flexible, and that's it. I hope you liked the video, and if you like it, please subscribe to the channel and press the like button, and see you next time. Thank you.